that of all the rectangles inscribed in a given fixed circle. That means one circle is given to us and rectangle is inscribed in that. So we will make one circle. Okay, one rectangle is inside the circle. Now, the square has the maximum area. So this is our function. Now, in a word problem of maxima minima question, you have to keep in mind three things. First thing, one quantity will be given to you. Another quantity that we have to show or to prove. And the another quantity in which you have to show maxima or minima. So the quantity for which you have to show maxima or minima, that will be your function. Okay, and from the given thing you should start. So here see, given fixed circle, that means radius or diameter, if we suppose for a circle, that quantity or that dimension value we can treat as constant. Okay, a square has the maximum area. Area of a square we have to show it is maximum. Then show that of all the rectangles it is a square. That means the side, suppose x is a side of the rectangle x and y. Okay, and this is suppose diameter of the circle d. So this d is given because given fixed circle, so d value we will take as constant. X and y are variable because these are the sides of the rectangles. Now to prove that square, it is a square, that means we have to show both x and y are equal because in a square all the sides are equal. And another thing which we have to prove is maximum area. Area is maximum. So first we will suppose let d be the diameter of the circle. Now from the given thing, what we can write, this will be rectangle is there, therefore this angle will be 90 degree. So by Pythagoras theorem, we can write x square plus y square equals to d square. Now see, area of a square, it should be maximum. Now area of this rectangle we should find, isn't it? That is x into y. This is our function, but it is in two variable case. So we have to make it in one variable case. So from this equation, we can write y square in terms of x or x square in terms of y, no problem. Okay. So what we will do, we will write x square suppose or y square as d square minus x square. Okay. So y will be root d square minus x square. Now I will write y value, this root d square minus x square. Let A denotes the area of rectangle. So A will be x, A will be equals to x into y, length into breadth. So we can write here, since we got A as xy, y value also we got here, that is d square minus x square. See, to remove square root, what we will do is squaring both the side. So we will get A square is equal to x square. This root term will go. Now this is A square is also one variable only. So we can take as any other number z suppose. So x square d square minus x raised to 4. Now differentiate with respect to x. So dz by dx will be, d square is a constant, so 2x or 2d square x will come here, 4x cube. Okay, now next step, put dz by dx as 0. So 2d square x minus 4x cube will be 0. So we will get here 2d square x is equal to 4x cube. See, this x will go, and 2 also will go. So d square will be 2x square. So d we can write root 2x, or x we can write d by root 2. Okay. Now we will find, we will check double order derivative is positive or negative. So we will find dz square by dx square. So this function we should differentiate once more. So 2d square will be constant. Derivative of x is 1. 4 threes are 12x square. Now at x equal to d by root 2, we should check d square z by dx square value, isn't it? So 2d square minus 12. X square is what? Directly from this expression we can write d square by 2. Okay. So 2 sixes are, answer is minus 4d square, which is negative. Therefore, z is maximum. But z is what? A square. So we can write, therefore, area is maximum. At which point? At x equal to d by root 2. Now, x value we got here. We will check what is y value. So we should prove that area is maximum when that rectangle is a square. That means x and y should be equal. So we'll find y value and we will check whether we are getting y as same as x or not. So y and x relation also we have, that relation we'll use. X value we got as d by root 2. Y value we know already, it is d square minus x square. So we will substitute here x value, so d square by 2. D square by 2 we will get after cross multiplication, that is d by root 2. So see, x and y are same, so therefore area is maximum at x equal to y is equal to d by root 2. That implies area is maximum when rectangle is by square. Question is, show that the right circular cylinder of given surface and maximum volume is such that its height is equal to the diameter of the base. In previous question also I told you that maxima and minimum question will contain of three parts. One thing will be given to you. So here see given surface area. So if we suppose surface area as S, so this S we can treat as constant. Maximum volume, that means V will be maximum. So this V will be our function and it should be in one variable form. Then one thing we have to show, that is height is equal to the diameter of the base. This we have to show that. So this is proving statement. Okay, all the maxima minima question will contain these three things. One will be given to you, one quantity you have to maximize or minimize, and another you have to show something or you have to prove. So what we will do first, let R, H, S and V be the radius, height, surface area and volume of the cylinder. So we'll start from the given thing, given surface area. Okay, so what is the surface area of the cylinder? It's 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. Okay, now here if you see, we have to find one relation between r and h. Okay, so see, we have to show height is equal to diameter, h and r. So we can find r in terms of h or h in terms of r. So but if you see, r square term is also there, r is also there, so it will be too complex to find function in terms of r in terms of h. So what we will do, we will write h in terms of r. So see what will happen. First we will shift this 2 pi r square to the other side, 2 pi r h. Now h is what? S minus 2 pi r square by 2 pi r. Okay, so h we can write s by 2 pi r, and here only r will remain, 2 pi cancel after separating the denominator. Okay, now h we got in terms of r. Now our volume should be maximum. So volume, this is our function. So volume of the cone, sorry, cylinder is what? Pi r square h. This is our function which is to be maximized, and this is in two variable case, r and h. So what we will do, we will substitute h value here to get this function in one variable form, that is only r form. Okay, so pi r square we will write as it is. H value is s by 2 pi r minus r. So what we can do, we can open the bracket. So pi value will go, one r will go. So s r by 2 will remain, and here pi r cube. Okay, now this is our function in terms of one variable. Now the other step, what is the common step? First find derivative, then put that derivative equal to 0 to get the critical points. Then double order derivative equal to is greater than 0 or less than 0, that we have to check. So differentiate with respect to r. So dv by dr. Here see s by 2, since s is given, I told you we can treat this as constant. The derivative of r is 1. Here pi is constant. Derivative of r cube is 3r square. Okay, now this expression will substitute as 0. So dv by dr we got as dv by dr is s by 2 minus 3 pi r square. Now next step is put dv by dr as 0. So s by 2 minus 3 pi r square is 0. So s by 2 equals to 3 pi r square. That means x equal to 6 pi r square. Now we will find double order derivative to check whether it is positive or negative. So we'll differentiate this statement again with respect to r. So d square v by dr square is, see now this x by 2 is, derivative of s by 2 will be 0 minus 6 pi r. So derivative, second order derivative we got as minus 6 pi r. Now if we substitute r value from this step will be root s by 6 pi. So if we substitute r value here, it will be negative only. See, minus 6 pi and r is s by 6 pi. So we will get minus 6 pi s, so which is negative. So we can write, therefore volume is maximum at s equal to 6 pi r square. Now we should show that height is equal to diameter of the base. Okay, so we have one relation of height. So now we will substitute this s value in that expression. So h is what? S minus 2 pi r square by 2 pi r. But s value we got 6 pi r square minus 2 pi r square by 2 pi r. So 4 pi r square by 2 pi r. See, pi will go, 2 to the 4 and 1 r will go. So we got here h equals to 2 r. 2 r is what? Nothing but diameter. So here we proved that volume will be maximum when height of the cylinder is equal to diameter of the base. Question number 21. Of all the closed cylindrical canes, right circular, of a given volume of 100 cubic centimeters, find the dimensions of the can which has the minimum surface area. Now here see, one thing is given to you, that is volume, given volume of 100, that value is already given. Okay, find the dimensions of the, this we have to find. Okay, and minimum surface area, that means surface area will be minimum this time, we have to show. So our function will be surface area, and that should be in one variable case, isn't it? So what we will do, we'll start with the given thing, and before that we'll suppose all the dimension here, r, H, S and V be the radius, height, surface area and volume of cylinder. Now from the given thing we'll start. Volume is 100, but volume we know volume is pi r square h, but it is given 100. Okay, now see what we can do. Surface area we know, surface area is 2 pi r r plus h, isn't it? So what we can do, we can write r in terms of h or h in terms of r. So here better write h in terms of r, because r square will be 100 by pi h, that times r we should find, so root term will come. So to avoid root term, you can substitute h value is 100 by pi r square. Okay, so this is h. Now surface area is 2 pi r r plus h. So h value, this should be in one variable case. This function we should find it is minimum or maximum. So this should be in one variable case. So we will change h value in terms of r. Now open the bracket. So 2 pi r square will come. And here 200 pi r divided by pi r square. But pi will go, 1 r will go, isn't it? So s value we got here, 2 pi r square plus 200 by r. Now this is a function which is in one variable, that is r. So differentiate with respect to r. So ds by dr will be, see 2 pi is constant, derivative of r square is 2r. Here 200 is constant, coefficient 1 by r, derivative of 1 by r is minus 1 by r square. So ds by dr we got here 4 pi r minus 200 by r square. So ds by dr we got 4 pi r minus 200 by r square. Now next step is what? Put ds by dr equals to 0. So 4 pi r minus 200 by r square will be 0. So 4 pi r equal to 200 by r square. 4 pi r cube will be 200. So r cube we can write 200 by 4 pi. That is 50 by pi. Okay. R cube is 50 by pi. So r will be 50 by pi. 1 by 3 or cube root also you can write. So we need to find the dimension. So r value we got, but we should check whether at this r what will happen to double order derivative. So this expression we will differentiate again with respect to r. So see 4 pi r derivative of r will be 0. So 4 pi minus 1 derivative of 1 by r square will be 2 by r cube, minus 2 by r cube, already minus is there. Okay, so 4 pi plus 400 by r cube. So r value if we substitute here, now at r 50 by pi 1 by 3. So d square s by dr square will be 4 pi plus 400. R value is, see r cube, but already with r 1 by cube is there. So this 3, 3 will go, isn't it? So 4 pi plus 400 pi by 50 will come. So 12 pi, which is maximum, which is greater than 0. So we can write s is minimum, isn't it? Surface area is minimum at r equal to 50 by pi 1 by 3. So one value, one dimension we got r. We need to find the second one, that is height. So we have one relation between height and radius that we will use here. So since we know height is 100 by pi r square. Okay. So pi 50 by pi R value is 50 by pi 1 by 3, but here already power 2 is there, so 2 by 3 we can write. This 100 we can write 50 into 2, so pi into 50 2 by 3 and pi 2 by 3, isn't it? So we can write C, indices rule we can use here, 51 minus 2 by 3 into 2 and here pi 1 minus 2 by 3. So, cross multiplication in power will give 50 power 1 by 3 and here pi power 1 by 3. So, H will be 2 times 50 by pi 1 by 3. So, these are the dimensions R and H value at which surface area is minimum.